listened to one of his wives, Aisha, in all the books of hadith, including Bukhari, Muslim, Sahih ibn Majah, with Tirmidhi, Musnad ibn Hanbal, from the brother's side. You know, when they speak about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they say Aisha was asked, how was the Prophet at home? What sort of a man was he at home? You know, what was his behavior at home? Listen to the description. She said, كان في خدمة أهله ما لم يؤذن للصلاة فإذا أذن للصلاة كنا لا نعرفه ولا يعرفنا. الله أكبر. The Prophet, she says, was in the service of his family until it is the call for prayer. When the call of prayer is heard, he would not know us and we wouldn't know him. Khalas, he's with God now. He's with Allah. But in between, from the time, from right when he wakes up until the time of Salah, if he's at home, he's not attending to community work or to the mosque or whatever the case may be, or when he comes back from the mosque to rest, he was in the service of his family. What does that mean? In the service of his family, right? Listen to this example. Rasulullah goes to the house of Fatima in the company of Amirul Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullah wa salamuhu alayhi. They enter the house, they found a Sayyidah Zahra, salamullah alayha, sitting down and grinding the wheat. Two wheels, two rocks with a, you know, some space in between, a handle. She puts the wheat and she grinds it. While she's doing this, she had Imam al-Hasan on her lap, on the side of her lap, right? And a broom which was, resting against one of the walls of her house. So Rasulullah came in and he said to Imam Ali, choose one of the tasks. He didn't say, you know what, son-in-law, mashallah, you have a great wife. I know what I've raised. She's doing all the tasks. Let's me and you chillax over Shisha. Astaghfirullah al-Ali al-Azim. This is what men do these days, unfortunately. I told you I will not be brought back to London. I know. Doesn't matter. Right? He said, choose one of the tasks. Was it too great for Amir al-Mu'mineen to choose a house chore? No. Because manhood is not by being inflexible and being chauvinist. Manhood is to be in the service of your family. That's what makes you a man. That's what makes you a real man. So Amir al-Mu'mineen, you know what he chose? He took the broom and began to sweep the floor of the house. Now these days, if you see someone vacuuming, says, oh, who's wearing the skirt at home? Ajeeb. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-ali al-azim. If a man helps his wife vacuum the house, all of a sudden he's wearing the skirt? Look at these concepts. They are so shameful to be entertained in this day and era. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam would not even entertain them 1400 years ago. You know why? Because he came to challenge the status quo. The status quo of then was what? Was that this is above a man's position and status. Rasulullah came to change that concept, that negativeness in the mindset of those Arabs. What did Rasulullah do then? He said, then I will grind the wheat. I'll take over from Fatima. Salawatullah wa salamu alayhi. Fatima said, then in that case, I will mind Hassan and Hussein. This is family at its best. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Surely, in the example of Rasul, surely in Rasulullah, you had the best example for those who what? لمن كان يرجو الله, for those who seek God. واليوم الآخر وذكر الله kathira. Rasulullah is an example, a role model, a paradigm in that regard. So when you want to look at family life, look at it from the position of compatibility, from the position of completing one another. I complete my wife and she completes me in everything that we can do at home, right? One of those contributors to successful marriage is the concept of being flexible. Many couples unnecessarily make themselves miserable because they are unwilling to bend a little. We should not expect our spouses to be our own extensions. She has to like the food I eat, the way I sleep, the time I sleep, the movies I watch, the games I like. Is she a robot? She doesn't like football. She doesn't watch football. You force her to sit with you and watch football, I'll tell the sisters. If that pleases your husband, also don't be inflexible. Sit with him. Make him feel happy about his team. It's not the end of the world. Right? Vice versa. If your wife wants to watch a particular program, of course, when I speak about programs, I'm speaking about halal programs, right? Within the parameters of religion. If she wants to watch a particular program and you don't like it, don't make an issue out of it. Sit. If she's happy, don't watch the program, Yami. Just hold her hand and say to her, I love you. Right? You know, sometimes people laugh when a sheikh talks about these issues. Al-Imam Sadiq salawatullah wa salamuhu alayhi has an interesting statement that not even Hollywood and the creators of Hollywood thought about it before Imam Sadiq salawatullah wa salamuhu alayhi. He said one statement, one word a man says to his wife, she will cherish for the rest of her life and she will never forget it. Your Imam Sadiq is saying this, not me. Don't look at me weirdly. Look at Imam Sadiq with an open eye, with an open heart, and take his statement on board. He said one statement, a man says to his wife that she will never forget for as long as she lives, when he says to her, I love you. Imam Sadiq. You know, one day I was in Africa. I don't want to say where in Africa. And I was giving a similar talk. A man aged between 65 and 70 came to me after the majlis. He said, come here, son. I said, yeah, I was like 33 then. He said, what are you doing trying to corrupt our ways? I said, astaghfirullah. I'm not trying to corrupt you. He says, do you expect me now with my gray hair to go to my wife and say to her, I love you? I said, wallah, wallah, if you do, you will get the best massage you've ever had in your life. And I'm sure at 65 you want it because you're cracking up. Arthritis has kicked in, osteo, God knows what, so you better try it. It's for your own benefit, uncle. Wallah, and you will come tomorrow and you will give me a bouquet of flowers for what I'm telling you. The guy went, came back, he said, you know what? I'm telling my wife I love you every hour. The things I got yesterday night, I never dreamt of. The best dinner, the best, you know, dessert, the best sleep, the best comfortable bed, you name it, I got it. I said, see, I should have come to Africa a long time ago. You know, maybe you've enjoyed a better lifestyle. These are notions that do not need a religious person to tell you, or a Quran to tell you, or a prophet to tell you. Wallah, they are by default human values. You want to be a man? Be that man. At home. You want to be a real wife? Be Fatima. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. Look at Fatima, what she did. One day, Amir al-Mu'mineen comes home. He sees Fatima pale. Pale. Yellow. He says, Ya Zahra, Ya Qurrata Aini, Ya Habibata Fuadi, O Zahra, the love of my heart, the beauty of my eyes, Allahu Akbar, 839. Ya Qurrata Aini, my beloved, why are you pale? She says, it doesn't matter. I don't know. Maybe it's sickness. I don't know. She's not lying. I don't know means she's saying it's all good, you know. He says, no. أَقْسَمْتُ عَلَيْكِ بِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ I take an oath with you by the blessing and the love you have for your father, Rasulullah, to tell me what's happening. She said, I haven't been eating well. He says, why? You have been serving me with food regularly. How come you have not been eating? She said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, the food I have been serving you was actually part of it my portion. But because we didn't have enough, I passed my portion to you. Amir al-Mu'mineen says, Ya Fatima, why didn't you inform me? She said, I do not wish to overburden you. He said, no. Finances of the family are my responsibility. I would have worked extra hours to earn more so I can provide more food. This is a woman that you want to marry. This is a man that you want to be with.